action continues here. The World Combat League inside the James L. Knight Center. The ladies back in the ring. Trish Leo, the victor, first time out tonight against Marisol Vidal-Ortiz. Ortiz trying to rally the Strikers. Strikers won their first match of the second half.
You know, Ortiz, I'll be honest, it was a very, you know, three-point margin in this league is an extremely close fight. You know, it's almost a victory for Ortiz because they really didn't expect her to be able to handle the power of Trish Leo.
Leo was on the attack a lot in their first meeting earlier in the first half.
She seems a little sluggish to start off here, whether she's just kind of resting up to get things going or not, but Ortiz is definitely coming out in her face, throwing more techniques right now.
You know, World Combat League, team fighting, two halves, and you fight twice in one night, provided you don't get KO'd, obviously, and at 6 minutes, how does that sit for a fighter?
Well, I mean, when you say 6 minutes to the average fighter, it doesn't seem like that much. It's actually the pace of these matches that make it that. Each 3 minutes is a fight in the sport, so each, you know, so basically what you're getting is a 15-round fight in 3 minutes, and that's kind of the distinction. These guys are throwing a lot more techniques and a lot more stuff than you would normally see in the average kickboxing or boxing match. And that's really what we're seeing here it's like a sprint. And a sprint is exhausting. Whether you're on a 50-yard sprint or a 100-yard sprint, it's exhausting. And that's what this is. It's a sprint fight.
And we're seeing some of that come into play there. You saw Trish leaning in on Marisol a little bit. Both fighters probably a little bit tired, obviously. Minute and a half left. And spinning back kick.
Block. Just showing the power that she has there. She just knocking Ortiz around with just her power.
Leo got a little bit of a lesson there on that. She kind of turned her back and was starting to walk away. And Marisol stayed on the attack.
Yeah, she scored some great techniques.
And New England gets a penalty point.
Yeah, Trish was holding, but she got a penalty point. Last minute, they're picking it up. And this is the interesting change in tides here. Look at Ortiz, she's backing up Trish Hill. Trish Hill is by far the more powerful fighter. Everybody knows this, you know? And she is being backed up by the less powerful fighter. It's changing.
Look at the momentum shift here, as you just mentioned, guy. Another penalty point holding again. So New England already 2 points ahead in this match. And we talked earlier, something had to be said in that locker room at halftime. Something has occurred because these New England fighters are coming out. Katie barred the door. They're giving everything they've got. And another penalty point. Hold it again.
I think this is just fatigue at this point. I think this is where you're seeing the ring rust on Trish Hill. She is, like I said, she is such a great fighter. I think the new style of fighting is kind of throwing her off a little bit, plus her inactivity. Now here's the total gym replay. You just see the combinations. Here's that spinning heel kick. Even though it was blocked, look how it knocked her completely off balance. It just shows the power Trish had. Here's Ortiz on the attack. And that was a four-punch combination, all that landed.
I did what I could, you know. Should have brought it in more and got out of the way. I mean, I learn every time I fight.
And that's testament there to Marisol, just working all the way through the fight. And despite the effort, somewhat of a surprise, but add in the penalty points, and we are tied at 14-all for the fight.